Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. It is your girl, I Eat Fashion. Today we are doing another Sunday Soul Food. So we are gonna be discussing what we learned in church over the past couple of weeks and sharing with you guys just all about what we've been hearing in the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah, amen.
So yeah, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe at the end of this video or now. Go ahead and do it right now. I think it's best. And so also you guys, this stranger that's sitting right beside me, I didn't even like, if y'all don't already know who this is my sister. This is my best friend. This is my dog. Her channel right across the screen is Hawaita.
Pause this video. Pause.
Go subscribe. Okay.
Go subscribe. Don't even watch this if you ain't even subscribed.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. So guys, this topic,
yeah,
you know, the pastor discussed be like, you know who you be, and yeah, we do know English, it's just a saying, okay,
right?
So you know who you be. So my first notes I have, and like I said, we take notes and then we try to explain it to you guys the best way we know how, and we can just break it down from that. So we have the question over your struggle is how you respond. God never loses. So let's elaborate on that. The question over your struggle is how you respond. Let's just say I'm going through something, all right? Stuff is gonna happen, like, so if you're going through something, remember, your Father, the ultimate Messiah, like God, Jesus Christ, like, he's on your side. Right. So it's up to how you respond, and that's the outcome that you're gonna get.
Exactly. So it doesn't matter what you're always gonna go through things in life. It's just how you respond to it. Are you responding like you know that you got somebody that's gonna have your back? Are you responding like you don't know? Are you relying on your own self to get a resolution with whatever you're going through?
Exactly.
So you just have to go back to that secret place that you guys watched the previous video.
Check
that secret place and, you know, check and with God and figure it all out.
Yep. Yeah. And then also in the previous video from Sunday Soul Food also talked about emotions, and it kind of relates to what she said. Like, are you responding in a way that you know God got your back? Are you responding off your own emotions? Because when we respond off our emotions, that's when we like basically let our emotions control us, and we like wavy, we like inconsistent, we don't have a consistent flow, we don't have no balance. So look at it that way. And you can control your reaction, but you cannot control someone else's.
Exactly.
Hope you're ready to see what he has over your life. You can focus on problem or promise. Which would you strengthen today?
Ooh,
that's good.
Right, so just to back up what she's saying, you can focus on problem or promise. So what are you gonna adjust your life for? I have down, I'm ready for your promise means I'm ready to adjust, meaning I'm ready to change my ways to God's ways.
Amen.
So I can know I'm gonna be able to fulfill that promise that he has for me.
Yep, because it's like, put it this way. He gave an example, but I'm gonna use something related. It's like when God, if you were chosen to be a pastor, right? God saw you and he's like, all right, this person is able to, what is the word? Discipline himself to be that.
Right.
And in the process of disciplining yourself to fulfill your purpose or, you know, like get God promised to you, you kind of have to change who you are. You kind of have to like be a better person. So it's like, sometimes when we don't get our blessing fully, are we doing those things, those requirements to get that blessing,
right?
To reach our purpose, are we adjusting? Yes. Yep. It's like you got dope hairstylists out here. They didn't get there by just doing one or two hair. Right. They had to be consistent in their craft. They had to give great customer service. They had to get the word out there. So they had to find a system.
Right. That's true. And I have down every purpose in each season. You have to grow into it.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to walk worthy into the season you were called to. I have down, nothing can separate the love of God, even if you mess up, for a just man falleth 7 times.
Mm-hmm.
And so it doesn't matter, although you are walking with God, and you may fall, and you may, you know, backslide or do some sin, it doesn't matter, because a just man, a saint, a person who walks holy with God, they fall 7 times, and God still loves them, and still forgives them, and has mercy on them. So it doesn't matter. You can always come back to him.
Exactly, because he's our father, like your parent. Like when your kid mess up and you a parent, do you like get rid of them?
Right.
Do you throw them away? Like,
no,
they can do the craziest things.
Right. I love the example he gives, that his children's last name is still going to be his last name regardless if they get caught on TMZ fighting or something. They're still going to be his children.
Yep.
Regardless of what it is, you're still God's child. So you can sin. You could lie, cheat, steal, kill, whatever the sin is, and God is still God to you. God is still your father.
Your father.
God is still able there, able to it actually still, forgive you.
Yeah, if you're willing to do the work.
Yeah.
And speaking of the work, it also states that the attachment of responsibility comes with a promise. Like, basically, there is like a lot of responsibility. It's a lot of stuff that I want to be and that she wants to
right.
be. But it's responsibilities that come with that. I'm not just going to sit on my tail and expect things to happen because, oh, I got the look or, oh, I got the attitude. You have to get out there. You have to do the work. You have to adjust. So, yeah.
And that's how you meet God with getting your purpose. So, although you want to be a millionaire and you pray to be a millionaire, you pray and you pray, you pray, you still have to do your part and put in that work, and that's adjusting for God, and then that's how he's going to meet you halfway with whatever you want to be or whatever you want to do or whatever you want to achieve in life.
And it also say that basically you see somebody, I'm giving this example, doing great. What's the difference from you and them? Like, they're humans too.
Yep.
But the pastor said that it can be with anyone, but you must sustain.
Right.
God chose you to change into the person that can sustain.
Right.
So if you are not someone that can sustain to be that person you want to be, I'm sorry. It really ain't going to happen.
Yeah.
You can do all the prayer come and work. It's not going to happen. So if you want to be this hairstylist, or you want to be this makeup artist, or you want to be this YouTuber, you got to sustain. You got to do the work. I'm talking to myself.
Talking to me too.
You got to do the work to get the result. You got to be consistent. You have to sustain. So
right.
just remember that, okay?
Right. And so he did break also down the B's. So the topic was, I know who I be.
Mm-hmm.
And he did it in a sense of bees, like the actual insect bees.
Mm-hmm.
So he broke down each insect each type of bee. So there's drone bees
mm-hmm.
who impregnate, who all they do is impregnate. So.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's also worker bees who cook, clean, mm-hmm. kick out the dead bees inside the hive and protect the queen bee. And then
mm-hmm.
there's the queen bee who basically keeps order. And the way that she keeps order is by sending out a signal.
She keeps the order of the kingdom.
Mm-hmm,
Pheromones.
Yes.
A chemical that releases the influence behavior of the species.
Right. So she keeps that actual signal. So it's kind of like not comparing God to an insect, but it's kind of like the same thing. God's keeping us in order, but he sends out things.
Yeah, and he said this is a spirit that affects how you act.
Yeah.
Your vibe, your everything.
Yeah.
So King Jesus, his spirit should affect us. And if it don't, I question what species you are.
Yeah. So that's so true.
Yeah, that is deep, deep, deep. But he made that, what is it? He said
analogy,
that,
like.
He made that analogy because I feel like he related to everything.
Yeah.
And do you know, like, honey has all of the, what is the word he said? All of the enzymes, basically everything you need to live.
Sustain in life
as a human. Honey has all of that.
And it never spoils.
And it never spoils.
The good thing about honey is it does also crystallize where it looks like it's going bad, but
mm-hmm.
all you have to do is stir it up.
Yep.
So kind of like your relationship with God, or you know, you feel like it ain't going nowhere, or your own life is not going nowhere, but the moment you start stirring
putting in that work, attention, giving it what
back
it needs
to where it need to be. Yeah.
Yep. And when he started with a B, he said your performance cannot change your identity.
Right.
Your last name is still there. So God said, no matter what I got you. She stated that.
Right.
Don't let your performance change your identity. You call yourself a black sheep. You're choosing to be beneath.
Right.
If you know you're a ratchet, you can choose something else. I remember that.
Right.
Like, you know you're a ratchet. You're like, girl, no, I'm ratchet. Okay, so you know this and you're choosing to be ratchet. So now you can choose to be better.
Right.
If you don't know you're ratchet, that's different. He said, I like people who don't know they're ratchet.
Right. But if you know you do wrong, or if you know you should do better in something
else.
You can choose something else, and that's how you adjust, like earlier.
Basically. And then, like she was stating, the drone bee is a working bee. The queen bee use a wobble dance to communicate and give direction to where the food is.
Right.
So he also used that as an example, like you in church. Like, you were praising and worshiping and thanking God because basically, like, the devil thought he messed with me last week.
Yeah.
Well, this is what I turned out to be in my father's house. So I'm going to be happy regardless, and you are not going to steal my joy no matter what.
Right.
Praise and worship. Like, praise God. This is your sign of your appreciation. So while you're in church looking like this, man, again. Yeah, the game about to come on, man. Babe, how long he got? Stop it! Stop doing that in church. Oh, you in church?
Thinking you cute.
If you think you're so cute for you to get solution for your problems, why should God take his own time to go above and beyond and fix your problem? Say what you want. Talk to God. So it's the same thing. You go to church, you should go to church expecting a solution.
Right.
You go to church expecting results.
Doing that waffle dance to get, just like the queen bee, to get that what she does it just to communicate.
Yeah.
So praise God. Just
praise God just to communicate that we thank him, we appreciate him, we know he's there.
Right.
And he says, so your dance is not random. I'm sending a message. The enemy knows how much he messed with me, and I am sending a message that I'm good.
Exactly.
Most scientists don't know how bees fly. He did say that.
Yeah.
That was dope.
Because the weight of their body versus mm-hmm. their wings, they don't understand.
They don't understand how they can fly. So that relates to this. People can't understand how you are soaring with all you are going through, with all the weight you are carrying. Some people would be stressed and done, but God has designed you to be that way. God has wired you to win.
Right.
So, go ahead.
Ooh, I love the wire to win.
Yeah,
you are wired to win. Like from the beginning, from the moment you were born.
I'm gonna get to that. You gotta get it.
You were born.
Think about.
You came out of the womb.
Think about how many sperm cells
you swam past.
Let me Google this. A million, probably more sperm cells, and you are that little. Boom.
And look at you winning.
Look at you winning.
You beat the other sperms.
Basically. You beat a lot of sperms
you
to get
wired
here.
To
millions
win.
Of sperm. So from birth, you was wired to win. God spoke that over your life. So it's like everything we do moving forward is the choices that we make. It's the kingdom that we choose. It's how we choose to react.
Right.
So think about that. Just think about it. If somebody tell you who you think you are, you don't know about it. Girl, do you know how many sperms I got through to be here?
Yeah, exactly.
From birth?
Right.
Let's start there.
He even said before birth, God knew you.
Yeah.
Before you were formed in your mother's womb,
yep.
I knew you.
He knew who you were supposed to be.
Exactly.
He spoke over your life. You were designed to be a winner. So it's like, now that you're here, he's just asking you to do the work. That's
right. And you have to know who you be. So people who are struggling, like, no, I'm depressed. I don't know. Thing about this life is not just going good for me. You have to know who you are. You have to follow God, trust God, believe God, seek God.
Yep.
And you won't have those feelings anymore. Not to say that you're never going to feel discouraged or you're never going to go through bad times. But when you have that source and you depend solely on that source,
mm-hmm.
you're going to be good.
That's like having a parent. I know this is an interesting example. That's like having a parent with a trust fund for you. But you like, I'm going to go and I'm going to, you know, figure it out and work hard and do it the right way. But when you fall, you can call it a trust fund. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
God
that's
is
true.
Always there for you.
That's your trust fund.
That's your trust fund. He's better than a trust fund.
He's better,
When you fall, you got your father to go to. It's like literally, I never looked at it that way.
That's
true. Yeah, I never look. I pray, I thank God, and I appreciate God. But do you really appreciate God? Are you really? Appreciation also comes with respecting him as a parent.
Yeah.
You can tell your mama you respect her, but you coming home late at 2 in the morning when she tells you
to respect her.
Do you respect her? No, you don't. So it's like, take a step back. Reevaluate things. And think about if you respecting your first and your only and your freaking spiritual parent.
Yeah.
Think about it that way.
Before you make any decisions.
Before you make any decisions.
You should think about it if it's going to be respecting him or not. So
anytime you take your identity to your own hand, you are stating a mistake. And now doing it your way. With your identity come purpose. If you change your identity, you could be uncomfortable in your purpose.
Right.
So
that's a touchy topic.
That is a touchy.
2020 and everybody's doing different things like being transgender or you changing who God created you to be.
Like that is very, very touchy.
It's a touchy topic.
Listen, this is because, you know, when you say that, everybody like, oh, you don't like it.
Right.
Let me clarify that. Okay, I have gay friends. I know gay people. I don't have a problem. It's not even gay people because people are just people, period. You know what I'm saying? I don't have a problem. But then when it comes to, you know, my religion and my belief and what it is like, reading something like that, when you change your identity, it kind of make you uncomfortable of who you are supposed to be in the future.
Right.
So listen, what you do in your spare time is you. I would love you regardless.
Exactly.
Because I love everyone. But this is just to look at it from a different spectrum, right? So when you're born and you're born this person, and God was like, Hawaita is going to be supermodel or the first lady. But then I decided to change my entire identity. And that just isn't with sexuality. That's with just
anything. Yeah.
Anything. Sometimes we choose to do stuff that is easier for us.
And it wasn't part of our purpose.
It wasn't part of your purpose.
And that's why our life goes the way that it does.
So exactly.
Not even just sexual. I'm glad you said that.
But it's not just sexual.
Not just sexual. But in general, God created you and he makes no mistakes. So if you're saying that who you are and what you're currently doing is a mistake, or you shouldn't be here, or you feel like quitting or giving up or committing suicide, that's wrong, because
mm-hmm.
God doesn't make no mistakes. So the fact that you are here, it's a reason, it's a purpose.
It's a purpose.
Yeah, so.
And you just need to work through all the distractions and all the devil has to offer on earth and try to figure that out and fight through what you have, because freaking, I feel like your purpose is not going to be easy.
Right.
You're like, oh, this is so easy. No, that's not your purpose.
Because he pushes you.
Yep.
For
he
better.
Pushes your purpose.
He said it. Like,
that's
if you're
a hobby.
A farmer, and you're wondering why so-and-so's yard got all the crops and all mm-hmm. of the harvest. You got to actually do the work. Go out
yep.
there in the sweat and sun, pick and pluck and
do
feed.
Stuff.
And, yeah, so it takes time to actually develop and get your harvest and get your purpose. So it's going to take you time to get your purpose and get
yep.
your harvest.
You cannot be cheap. He also may remember this example. You cannot go to Broadway, right? If you're acting in a play on Broadway, you guys rehearse everything. So we rehearse in a play, and I'm supposed to say to Chica, "Hi there, ma'am," and she's supposed to say hi back. We rehearse that, but if I go and say, "Yo, I'm hungry," she don't know what to say back. That's not in the play.
Right.
So you can't go on stage and change the scene. I'm going to read
from
that.
From what the creator made.
From what the creator made. He said, you can't go on Broadway and choose your role. You can't change your role on set. If you do, the others wouldn't know how to reply. The purpose of believing is to become. Continue to believe until you become. This is why the devil is the father on lies. Because he knows the power of an individual who know who they be.
Right.
Boom.
So basically, if you going on Broadway.
Boom, yeah.
Yeah, so if you're living your life and God says, you know what, I'm creating Desiree. And she's gonna be a person who's going to touch other women and other individuals.
Mm-hmm.
And she's going to start a YouTube channel and she's going to do Sunday soul food.
Yeah.
And I say, you know what? I ain't talking about God in my videos. I'm only going to do makeup.
Yeah.
I'm only going to do makeup and weed. Because
I don't want people talking about me. You know, I don't
want
to. Let's have that conversation real quick. I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah. So that's changing the role of what the creator made.
Yeah.
Not saying he made me to do YouTube, but I'm just saying in general. If a creator writes out a play and he says, this is going to be a girl doing this, and I say, no, I don't want to do that. I want to act like a horse. I want to change my identity to be
a
horse.
And you're trying to do this on stage the day of the play.
Yeah, you can't do that.
You can't do that.
And that's how the creator made you.
Yeah.
So.
Your life is a stage, and he already knows every part. Everyone's somebody to play. You have people around you that's in your life that are supposed to reply to this play and this role. But when you change your true identity, they don't know how to
react.
Maybe she's supposed to help me, I don't know, start my business with I need some of my hair business. I don't want a hair business. I'm giving an example. Start my hair business. But I decided to go do, let me do shoes. And it's like, I'm never successful at shoes because I'm not doing hair. And she does hair. We don't, you know, communicate like that because I do shoes. So it's like her purpose in my life is not fulfilled because I'm not sticking to my true identity.
Right.
I hope that makes sense.
Right.
It's like because something is easy for you in life, that's not your purpose. I'm not saying don't do it, girl. You get the money. Go ahead and make your queen.
Exactly. So how do you find out what your purpose is? We're all here. We all got to work 9 to 5. We all got to wake up. We just do the same routine. How do we find our purpose? What are some
having a relationship with God.
Boom.
Go into your secret place.
Boom.
You got to be able to hear it. You. Some people say sometimes, well, somebody told me this and then somebody told me that. Be able to listen to the right voice.
Right.
And we know
and identify.
How. It's like right now you may be in a situation where somebody broke up with you. Somebody left you. You don't know how you're going to pay your bills. You don't know how you're going to feed your kids. You don't know how you're going to go to school. You sick. You worry about a disease. You could be dying. It doesn't matter what it is.
Right.
I'm here to tell you today, homie. Do you know who you are?
Right. Do you know who you be?
Do you know who you be? Think about that time. And I don't know that time, but you know. Think about the times in your life that you have conquered. That you was at your last. That you didn't know how you was going to survive. And you are here to this day. And you always get through it. So right. Let me ask you this question. What are you tripping for?
You already know who your source is.
You already know
you're a child of God. You already know your father is the number one supplier. He will give you anything you need.
Anything, just ask.
And he always comes on time. His timing is the best time. So why are you complaining? Why are you stressing? Why are you having anxiety over things that don't even require you to even fret? Like, you should be okay.
And when you also said, and I don't think it was this topic, but just in general, when you at a point when you can't figure it out, You like testing your faith. Keep it strong because that's God showing you, hey, it's my turn. Tag me. I got this.
Right.
When you don't got it, he got it.
Right. And he just right beside you. Like, I've been here. I've been waiting for you to pray. You crying over this. I've been waiting for you to call on me. And cry to me. I got the answer for you. I'm sitting right here on the couch and you crying right now.
You want
to
act that out too? I'll be. Yeah, and he also said, do you know who you are? The head and not the tail.
Yeah.
I am fearfully and wonderfully made.
Right.
I was designed to win. So we are faithfully and wonderfully made.
Fearfully and wonderfully
the
made.
The person that made us, how can it be anything else?
Right.
The devil didn't make you, so why are you turning to him?
Right. God called you to be the head and not the tail.
And
so
not
you
the
are
tail.
Above and not below. You're not beneath.
You're
so
not
why
beneath.
Are you stooping down to other levels?
Boom.
Why are you thinking low of yourself? Why are you wanting to hurt yourself and harm yourself? And
why are you doubting who you are?
Right.
I feel like a lot of people's problems is like they don't know their secret place.
Right.
They don't, their faith is not strong.
Right.
And listen, everyone is out here don't believe in God, and everyone don't have, some people are on the fence, da da da. But it's like, what is it going to hurt you just to try?
Right.
What is it going to
try?
Try it out.
See if he fails you.
And you can talk to God. Like, literally, when you go talk to your mom and your daddy, do you always have to plan a speech?
No.
You can
talk to him.
Hey, mom. Man, mom tired. I'm hungry. Can I get some food? Talk to him.
That's what he wants to hear.
He wants to hear
from you.
You know, it's your girl again.
It's your girl.
It's been a struggle, but you already know that.
You already seen me this morning.
Yeah, but that thing that I said I was going to do, I ain't do, God, I'm going to try again this week.
I'm going to try.
Just talk to him. Like,
he's
going to
be there. And the fact that you take that one step, he's going to bless you even more.
Even more. Because it's like now you acknowledge me. Your mom buy you something, your dad buy you something, and you take the time out to thank them. And encourage them to be like, my kid is really appreciative. I'm going to do more. But that nappy head ball, every time I buy him something, he just grab it and run.
And use it and abuse it.
And abuse it. Why would somebody want to get you more?
Right.
So just, it's like everything just relates to our relation with God. Like,
it's better because, you know, even though we might do God like how we do our own physical mom and dad, we treat God, but God doesn't turn our back. He's still there like, I'm still here.
Yep.
I haven't left you. I still love you. I don't care.
Yep.
You did that? I don't care. Come back to me.
Yep.
I'm still here for you.
He even said that, do not let the devil whisper lies about your identity to you. So I gave you an example, and we stated that earlier. Oh, you go to church, huh? But why are you having problems?
Right.
Oh, you faithful, huh? To God, but why are you still tripping? Oh, you can't pay your bills, but you go to church.
But you believe in a God, and you can't pay your bills.
And she doing good. Girl, go make some extra money. It's like, it's just that whisper. Because we have that thought.
Yeah,
as humans.
As a human. Yeah.
You like, man, I'm about to go do a little song for some change. Whatever your song is, I'm just saying. So don't think what your song is what I'm talking about. This is something.
It might be something.
There might be something. You know what I'm saying? So it really depends. And he also said, stop doubting who you be. Don't let your circumstances define who you be.
Right.
So if I know I'm a great queen, I'm amazing, I am marvelous, I am smart, just because I had a little situation with a friend or somebody break up with me, or I would even make it bigger, or somebody maybe put something of me on Instagram that was embarrassing to everyone, not everyone think, that still doesn't change who God designed me to be.
You know who you be.
Because I know who I be.
Right.
So don't ever change because of the situation. Knowing who you be could help the situation.
Exactly.
He said, I can be broke but still rich, blind but still see, weak but still strong.
Genesis 32:24-26.
Yep. Jacob was left alone. Most of us can never get into our purpose because we're never isolated.
Oh yeah, so isolation.
Isolation, okay, so. Facebook, IG, Snapchat, YouTube. He said isolation because sometimes, I ain't gonna lie, I do it too. You like get up work, you tired, you look at one social media, before you know, 30 minutes go by, you scroll. Well, I don't know about 30, but maybe like 5. I'm still scrolling, so it's like, girl, you could've like freaking do something with that 5 minutes to invest in you instead of just sitting here scrolling on stuff that's not productive to your life.
Right, so he basically mentioned Genesis 30, chapter 32, verse 24 through 26, mm-hmm. when Jacob was wrestling with an angel. And so the angel wrestled him until daybreak, basically asking him, what's your name? Who are you? And he kept saying, I'm Jacob. And he said, no, you are Israel. So sometimes you have to isolate yourself because although Jacob, the whole story was Jacob was traveling and he brought people along. But sometimes you have to isolate yourself because mm-hmm. soon as he isolated himself, an angel came and he wrestled with him on his identity of who he was.
He was able to, basically with the whole identity thing, it's like, all right, so big YouTubers. Let's name who's somebody that have a different name that's not a real name. So basically, when people ask you who you are, I am Etawaita. I have YouTube. I do this. You that's not your true identity.
That's not your true identity.
You are just naming
that's a part of
yeah.
You.
You're just naming stuff that is like what people labeled you as, right. Basically. But you gotta know your true identity. Like right. Who am I?
Who are you? When she gets around her coworkers, she's Hawaii to the manager, but when she comes home, she's Hawaii to the wife, mm-hmm. and then when she's around me, she's Hawaii to the friend. But you have to know who Hawaii to, yeah. to know who Hawaii to is to know what she is and what she can do to benefit other people.
There you go. So you know, achieve her true purpose.
Right.
So don't let all these like labels. Earthly and worldly labels go to your head.
Right.
Like that's just supposed to stay at a certain place. Find time, challenge yourself to find your true purpose.
Right.
And honestly, I think this is my true purpose. I don't know about y'all, but what you think?
I'm feeling real good about it.
I'm feeling really good.
So basically, y'all, from everything that we said and all the bits and pieces that we were trying to get to y'all is just know who you be, know who you are in church, in Christ. And when you know that, it changes. Yeah, it falls. Everything falls in place. You know who you are. You are able to handle different circumstances different. You're able to move through life different. You're able to have different outcomes and different strategies when you have that main source as your actual director and mm-hmm. provider for your situations. So yeah, I hope you guys like this. I hope you guys get something from this. Comment down below if you just have any thoughts or opinions on anything we mentioned. And I definitely want to thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you so much for tuning in. We'll catch you guys in the next video. Until next time, peace.
Peace. Don't forget to subscribe. Bloop.